again.
Stevie Wonder began to explore a funk sound with two musicians and recording engineers using a new musical invention, the synthesizer, TONTO.
We brought him out in the studio and Malcolm and I were like, would twiddle the dials and he would play the synthesizer and he'd start really getting into his head. Like that.
TONTO was installed in the studio which had been used by Jimi Hendrix, Electric Lady, and the trio got down to work.
He so enjoyed it that we didn't leave the studio. We worked day and night, weekends, holidays, birthdays, Christmas. It didn't make any difference. The time stopped, and we really went on to Stevie time.
You see what I'm talking about, the rubato?
Yeah.
It just lays way back.
Stevie's collaborators quickly realized that they were working with somebody special.
Stevie had such a breadth of musical capability, and he was also wide open to suggestion. I would sit down sometimes and play a few sort of jazz changes, and he immediately, oh, hey, show me that, what's that, show me that. And he would pick it up and then take it to a whole new place.
Working with TONTO, Wonder could experiment with the sound of funk.
Those were like fresh sounds, you know? You can play the same thing on a piano or on the organ, but it ain't gonna give you that same edge, that same flavor, or it don't touch you the same way. So, he bought a whole another dimension.
The Electric Lady Sessions produced four albums worth of material. From Talking Book came the number one hit, Superstition.
Oh, he's in funk heaven right there.
13-month-old baby.
Yes, Lord. Yes, he's funky. Yeah, he's most funky.
Keep me deep.
Definitely funky. You can't, I mean, you know, you can't cut that with a knife.
And then from the Inner Visions album, an inner city epic, Living for the City.
A boy's born in hot time, Mississippi, surrounded by...
But where Marvin Gaye used harmonies and jazz rhythms to sell the message, Stevie Wonder used a synthesized funk beat with an anger in his voice artfully captured by his co-producers.
Moving in the right direction, living...
We worked him hours. I'd stop the tape in the middle of a take, right, and it, to get him angry, to get that anger and that real feeling.
Just enough for the city.
We also tried to get this hoarseness in his voice. We kept on taking the same take over and over and over and over again. No, come on, Steve, you can do better than that. And we would just really tee him off. And it took a lot of doing because he's not naturally that way.
She's got to get up early. Her clothes are old, but never are they dirty. Living just enough for the city. Her brother's smart. He's got more sense than many. His patience long, but soon he won't have any. To find a job.
As Stevie Wonder funked it up in New York, the man who started the funk revolution powered his way into the 70s with a